y'all motherfuckers doing? Welcome back. Random TV Reviews, your girl Lynette.
And it's your boy, Stanley.
Hey, we coming in with Power Book 4-4, Season 1, Episode 4.
Storm Clouds.
Listen, yeah, man. We're going to get into this episode because, real facts, I still feel like we're developing a lot of the characters and reintroducing. So, I wish we were further along than that, but before we even get into that, let me go ahead and plug in powerinblack.com. Y'all know that's where we get all of our teas from. This one is from Target this week, though.
Yeah.
But this one right here, powerinblack. Use my
code. Good things that come to those who hustle, baby.
Use my code Lynette, L-Y-N-E-T-T-E. It'll save you 25% off your total purchase, baby.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man.
So, let's go ahead and get into this episode.
Yeah, man.
Because we got a lot to talk about.
Yeah. Like we definitely still in the, sort of in the character development stage. You know, stuff ain't really popping off the way that we really wanted to pop off on Power. But, hey, I'm here for the ride because I know it's getting ready to get really heated after this episode here. So we remember from last episode when Diamond tore Janar's tail up in the ring. So
we knew Janar said he let him win.
Yeah, according to him. So we already knew that they was not going to be on the same page because Elijah said in the last episode that you know that you faking this, it's going to be a dividing line down between CBI. So in this episode, he's at the barbershop talking to Elijah again. And he tells Elijah, hey, bro, I'd have sacrificed a lot to get this. I'm supposed to be going to college. And guess what? I can't get any of that skit back.
So you think I'm just going to hand this over to my brother? Because he's supposed
to do that. And I feel him on it, though. I really do. It's like, but at the same time, I wish that they could see eye to eye because both of them has a value that they can offer to their organization, man. But but when you want power, you can't see that.
But at the same token, why is Diamond in the game? Diamond said all the right things, just like somebody that's institutionalized. But come out, say the right things. I don't want to be a part of it. I just want to run my barbershop. I want to cut hair, get some coochie on the side. And right now, Diamond has every opportunity to not be in the game, if you ask me.
Right.
Like, everybody respects the fact that he wants to fall back. Janard, he wants him in, but he understands if he's not in, he don't really have to be working with Tommy.
Yeah.
So I'm like, this is just who you are. This is who you are.
So basically, this episode, he makes Diamond make a choice. It's either going to be, you know, this white boy, Tommy, to come along, and now you want to ride off on him with a tank, and y'all want to go and, you know, run skit, but you need to choose. Either it's going to be with us, or it's going to be with him. So now Janard is giving him an ultimatum is, okay, if we're going to still do this thing, and which we know is basically deception, because Janard, I believe at this point, is thinking about killing his brother.
I do too.
Yeah, so he's thinking about removing him off the board. And I think he's going to try to get Elijah to do it.
Elijah's
not going to do it because we saw that Elijah was like, bro, like, y'all need to get this kid together, man.
He said, I don't like this.
Yeah. So in this episode, Diamond and Tommy was at this restaurant. And those two dudes, I don't know who they name, it don't matter. But Tommy said, get me a cup of coffee. And them ninjas lost it. He was like, we've been slaving back here all day long.
To be Starbucks. I said, if that won't, when you go to your family house and they don't cook all this food and my family cooks, and you come to the house and be like, oh, I ain't hungry. What the fuck you mean you ain't hungry?
Yeah.
You better fix some plates or something.
Man, you get your a whoop for doing some skit like that.
Nah, it's straight disrespectful.
Yeah, man.
It's real disrespectful.
So we come to find out this meeting was with Vic. Vic comes into the restaurant. And Vic tells Diamond and Tommy, be like, hey, my dad is on some BS. I don't believe that y'all crew killed our men. That's not CBI style.
Diamond was like, okay, now you can sit down.
So this is when they started talking about taking over the territory of the Yardies. And so we see that they got together. And so the whole time that they were out still riding together, going to the yards, I was like, when is Vic going to address Tommy about bucking his girl?
Yeah.
I'm like, we got three episodes into him doing that, and you ain't saying skit to them, but yet
y'all riding together.
Y'all hanging tight.
Like, what's up with this threesome?
So when they get over to where the yard is at, they get a call from Elijah letting them know on the scanner, like, it's hot over there.
Yeah, I need to
get out. 5-0 is coming, you need to get out. But when 5-0 came through there, the black guy that works, that we found out works, the cop that works with the Flynns, we see him chasing whoever these dudes are. I guess those was the yardage that was in the truck, I guess. But it don't even matter. But he saw Vic. I said, oh, skit. That's going to be a problem.
That's going to be a
that
real
he saw
problem.
Vic. So
he saw Vic with Diamond and Tommy.
Yes. So if it had not been for Elijah, I think they all three of them got busted that day.
I still don't think they were, because that cop was going to cover. Because at the end of the day, they were right there still. And the cops were right on past them like, oh, okay. SUV, not suspicious at all. You know? Yeah. And they just went right on past them. So I think they still would have been good.
Think so?
Mm-hmm.
We see, of course, Walter finds out that Vic is working with them, and he just clean loses it. Half the time, I don't know what the hell he's talking about.
Put your damn hands out dead. Y'all remember that? All about the Benjamin? Look at this guy.
So he's telling Vic that you need to follow tradition. You need to do it the way we've always done it. And Vic is like, the way we're doing it, it's not working anymore. We're not going to survive pushing these goddamn pills. We need to come up where everything is at in the drug game. We losing. And Walter just still can't see it.
I'm sitting here still like, this man is acting as if he's not on his way out. Like,
yeah.
Ultimately, we all are on our way out. His number's just at the front of the line.
Yeah.
And he's acting like he's going to be around for forever. And you got your kids that have to take over this business. It's almost like when someone dies without insurance. It's almost like, bucket. You figure it out after I'm gone. That's what I feel like Walter Flynn is doing to his kids. Like, he's leaving them with a whole bunch of skit without an insurance policy. Like, when I'm gone, just figure the skit out.
Or do it the Irish way. That's not working.
And it's not working.
Yeah.
So we're still figuring it
we
out.
We still down 12%, man.
12.
We down 12. Finally, Vic confronts Tommy about bucking Gloria. But it wasn't until they was... Vic said, I got something to do. And they pulled over to Gloria's bar. And they was getting ready to go in. And Tommy was like, nah. And so that's when Vic confronts
her. And Vic is riding with Tommy.
Yeah, and I was like, this is when he finally confronts her, and Vic tell him that ain't gonna be for long. And I'm like, how in the hell you control that? Like, you ain't seen what we seen. Tommy been bucking that pretty good, bro.
Yeah, bro. They out there, they getting dehydrated. That's a different kind of buck when you get dehydrated. Yes, sir. That ain't just a little pump, pump, do, do. That's a work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's some work. Tommy putting in them long strokes.
Hey, white boy strokes. I don't know nothing about that because it's all black over here. I just love the fact that Vic think this, that his and Gloria's relationship has so much meat that she's still going to come back to him. I'm like, at the end of the day, you won't choose this girl over your family.
Right.
Well, publicly, that is. And like she said, you're not fighting for me. So she's bucking Tommy, but you still are like, okay, it's not going to last for long because we're on a little break. Y'all want more than a little break.
Yeah. Y'all broke up.
Yeah.
Y'all broke up.
You just the one that haven't disconnected your feelings. She got feelings too, but when a woman open her legs to another man, I mean, that means that you on your way out and somebody else on their way in.
Hmm. Good point. All right, so we know our girl, Claudia, is just making moves. You know, Claudia has been done with Walter a long time ago. She's sick of his skit. So she goes, which I believe is one of her family members, and puts him up on game with the drug. And she gives it to him, and he gives her...
It's like, whoa.
He places a pre-order. And his pre-order is basically, he just like... Barely sniffed his skit, and he was like, whoa, where'd you get this from?
Yeah.
She said, wrong freaking question, player. What's the freaking price? That's the question that you need to be asking.
Mm.
So I said, this is the start of when this drug is getting ready to hit the street, and that's where all the problems are going to cost. It's going to come up right from this drug right here. But my thing is now was... How is they going to produce this in mass quantity?
That's what I was getting to.
And I was like, because they only been, you know, she only been doing. Yeah. So she goes back and talks to old girl and was like, we need to produce this on a mass scale. who makes this? And the girl was like, me, I don't want to cook it. She was like, that's the skit.
Who does it for real?
And come to find out, she has a chemist that is a black girl.
We should have known.
Yeah. That's doing the cooking.
Create everything.
She's the chemist.
We create everything.
So Claudia basically twists her arm and says that if you don't, you know, if you don't cook for us or put this skit together for us, we're going to report you because find out in your FDA report, you left out some pertinent information. And you
falsified some skit.
So, you know, if you don't do this for us,
your license goes by.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm still kind of confused on old girl that's bucking Claudia because this week she had more of a fear thing when dealing with Claudia. Like, what the heck happened between last week and this week?
Because this is not the Claudia that was licking her between her legs. This is the business Claudia now. That's a whole new different ball game there.
Not doing it with you today.
Now it's about business.
You can have both.
Business before pleasure now.
Hey, we do both.
Yeah.
You can do both.
Hey, but we got contracts though. They ain't got no contracts. It's business time now.
I'm not doing this today.
Alright, so just like Tommy told Liliana, it's not if whoever these drugs are gonna be coming look for you is when. Mm-hmm. And so in this episode, them jokers showed up, the Serps. We thought it was gonna be the Jimenez, but we was like, didn't the Jimenez
all of them pretty much dead? So but I was like, that don't mean the whole organization is dead, but exactly. I didn't even think about the Serps.
So they come, man, I'm gonna tell you, Tatiana, boy, she can take a licking and keep on ticking. They be beating her. Hey, and they burnt her with a cigarette. The only way they could get a cigar, the only way that she would talk, they had to threaten to burn her eye.
I said, well, yeah, the eye is very important. I said, well, do I trust Liliana, though? I don't know.
I don't know, but we know, like she said, she's all about the money. She don't care.
Where the money resides.
That's where she resides. So she ended up going, taking a ride with them. So she sent a text to Tommy. And told Tommy that
meet me at such and bring ghosts.
So we see that Tommy comes, and shoots the two guys that picked her up. Now that Tommy know that it's the Serps that the drugs belong to the Serps, he goes to Diamond and told Diamond that hey, we need to make a move on him. And Diamond was like, oh no! It was like when you start with them. It's going forward, which we know that from when they was when Tommy and Ghostin was dealing with them in New York.
I gotta say, look at what we doing now. We in a whole nother state, and you still cannot escape the search.
We see that Tommy goes and meets them by himself.
What the hell is this?
And returns the coat. I was like, okay, so it's Tatiana that is gonna let him go that easy? When they had Liliana in the back of the truck, they kept on saying
Tommy Egan.
That kept on saying Tommy's name, but you remember Liliana told Tommy that, hey, the people that I know ain't looking for you. But they sure enough brought his name up in that truck.
And they kept a girl.
Yeah. And yeah, they kept saying she. So back to Tommy them out this, I was like, okay, so you coming by yourself, Tommy? You crazy. You get them coat back. They're gonna kill you. Yeah, they're gonna kill you. So things switched on us, and we saw that the two guys that she whooped was shot, and Vic showed up.
Vic said, now a minute. Thomas said, that's how you earn a cookie.
So I was like, so is Tommy gonna keep Tatiana alive? And so he ended up killing Tatiana too. And I was like, oh.
She was pleading for her life. Like, I really thought that Tommy was gonna. If Tommy would have did a ghost move, he would have let her stay. He would have left her alive. But he learned from the chick over here and the whole the foolishness to come along with that, nah, we got to kill her. Because she was like, I saved your life from Jason. You going to do this skit to me?
Yeah. Yep. I don't know what y'all think. I think that Tommy is going to blame this whole thing on Vic, and this is going to blow back on the Flynn family. Yeah, because after all, Tommy is dead.
He is dead.
He's dead.
And that's what he told up.
So how can Tommy kill Tatiana if he's dead? So let me find out. Tommy is trying to be ghost.
He is a ghost.
So before Tommy and Diamond had left to go talk about the Serps, Jannar had to babysit Liliana. But come to find out that he used to work for her, and not only he used
She used to work for
him. I mean, she used to work for him.
She used to cut.
Yeah, she used to be, And come to find out, he's trying to get in them drawers too.
She said, yeah. Every time I would cut for you, you were too busy trying to get into my pants. I was like, Jannard.
And you owe me money. And so...
I said, so how you gonna try to buck and you owe her money?
Yeah. So, he end up paying her, and he end up getting a kiss.
On the scar?
Yeah.
What kind of count?
So now we see Jannard got a thing for her. I don't know how far that's gonna go, but we know he got a thing for her. So now we got time, we meet JB's dad, and this was a funny scene. And JB's dad was like, anybody that's born from Kate can be sugar cones. And Tom was like, nah.
I'm not. He's like, so how bucked up are you?
But JB's dad starts talking about, you know, how much he loved JB and how much he loved being in his life and being there for him. And he didn't just, like JB said, I don't understand how somebody just walk away from their kids like that. But come to find out that JB has the same weakness that Tommy had. His dad said the thing about JB is he always led by his heart and not by his head. And that's Tommy, man.
Yeah. So,
but the thing about it, they mama is not led by her heart.
So where they get it from?
Where they get it from?
Y'all got two different daddies.
So yeah, that's what his dad said that JB's weakness is. So yeah, they are definitely brothers. But I was hoping to find out in this episode, because the dad also said that a lot of drama always follows JB. And asking Tama, are you bringing more drama in his life?
Yeah.
Are you doing that too? He was like, no.
He said, I think he had enough going on when I came on the scene.
But we know that Tommy eventually want to clean drugs through that bar. Mm-hmm. And we got to remember, also, we find out in this episode that the cop that works for the Flans, that he's doing that because his sister is sick. And Vic told him that, hey, in order for you to continue to do this, to take care of your sister, you can't do that on a cop's salary. And I thought about, I was like, everybody on this episode is sick. And you remember JB?
Yeah.
JB is taking care of his dad.
He looked good.
Yeah, he looked real good. But at the same time, with Tommy running things through that bar, that could mess up. If that goes south, how in the hell did JB gonna continue to take care of his daddy?
Right.
And all those medical bills. We left from that and we saw that D-Mac and the crew was getting ready to shoot up JB's bar again.
Again.
But this time, D-Mac saw him because JB came out there with a bat.
Like, you could see the hurt,
the
curiosity, all of that in one take. It was just crazy.
So JB was like, why do you keep on shooting up my place? And I thought that he was going to say,
Dad.
But he took off.
And where the other boy was prepared to kill him because they were going over there, shoot it up again. And the other guy was like, in the crew, like Diamond been saying, these are hotheads. All they want to do is pull
a
trigger.
Yeah, yep.
And he's talking about something. If we come over here, I'm going to take some stuff. You going to take out the box?
Yeah.
Like, y'all don't hit it so many times. What you going to take? Some 1738? I mean, some cruising.
Some Hennessy, man.
Some Hendo. Syrah. Like, this. How much that going for on the street? I mean.
Yeah. So now, because all these moves are being made and Tommy is doing his thing, which we know Tommy is trying to become the top dog, he basically playing all them against each other to be the top dog. That Tommy, I believe that Tommy wants all of them to be working for him.
Of course.
That's the end goal. So Tommy end up cutting it off with Glory of like, you know what, I gotta, you know, money.
Find me another bar.
Yeah, I gotta find another bar to go through because money before business. But you can see Gloria smiling like, BS. You gonna be back
gonna
for some of this.
This.
Yeah, you coming back to get some more of this. Mm-hmm. But that basically was the episode, man.
We know. Liliana was like, you know, a storm is coming.
Yeah.
And Tommy was like, oh, it's already here.
Mess around them syrups, so on a matter of time, man. Yeah, they coming.
Yeah.
They coming. So we're going to catch y'all, man, in the next episode of Power. Get down in the comments. Let us know what y'all think. And we're going to catch y'all next week. Straight from the VA.
The Dirty South.
Two up, two down. Holla. Boom.